Pro.
Dextech Pro.
What's up, guys? This is Dex, and you're watching Dextech Pro. In this video, I'll be discussing significant advancement in PlayStation 5 exploitation and covering the release of the first public PS5 Hypervisor exploit by Spectre that brings the console closer to the level of PlayStation 4 in terms of Homebrew development and customization. The major highlight in the PlayStation 5 scene is the release of the first public Hypervisor exploit by Spectre. This exploit represents a breakthrough in console exploitation, allowing for the use of the Homebrew application on PlayStation 5. It's a significant advancement in unlocking the PlayStation 5's potential, offering features similar to what we've seen with the PlayStation 4. The new Hypervisor exploit currently supports PlayStation 5 firmware version up to 2.50, making a notable improvement from previous methods. For users aiming to take advantage of this exploit, instructions are included to ensure proper usage along with guidance on maintaining compatibility with future firmware versions. This development follows Spectre's presentation at the hardware.io conference, where he first showcased the details of the exploit. Attendees got an in-depth look at the technical aspects and its broader implications for PlayStation 5 community. In this release, two types of exploits have been provided. The first one is the jump table exploit, which is an older method, and the second one, which is the newer version, is QA flags exploit, which is the recommended option due to its reliability. An exciting aspect of this development is that Homebrew Enabler, or HEN, is already supported for firmware version 2.50, signaling progress in the Homebrew scene and providing users more creative control over their console. For firmware version up to 7.61, stability has been achieved with the Blu-ray drive exploit. This improvement allows the exploit to run smoothly without kernel panics, which was a common issue in earlier versions. This increased stability is a big step forward for developers working with higher firmware versions. The ability to dump kernel data from the PlayStation 5 is another major advancement. This allows developers to gather the necessary offsets to port payloads to other firmware versions, which could significantly speed up the development of future exploits. Another notable development comes from one of the developers who introduced a tool designed to interface with PlayStation 5 hardware components. This tool is primarily useful for diagnostics and repairs, but could also aid in future exploit developments. The ability to access error codes and dump firmware from hardware components could just lead to more precise diagnostics and even more advanced hardware-level hacks. The PlayStation 5 exploitation landscape is rapidly advancing, with these developments paving the way for even more homebrew options and potentially new exploits. If you're following the jailbreaking scene, be sure to subscribe for more updates on PlayStation 5 developments and homebrew applications, and that's the end of this video. Thank you for watching and have a good one.
Subscribe to Dextech Pro YouTube channel.